You.
I love being home with you. I love being home with you.
It looks so sad.
Yeah, it's just, you know, I know we're homesteading. And I feel kind of sad that duck quackers is so tasty.
You felt kind of sad that what?
Quackers. It was quacking away.
It takes a little getting used to eating, you know, the animals we come to love. But
I know.
But you have to admit, my duck confit is pretty banging. It's top notch, bitch. It's top notch. I feel like the fear he had in his eyes. Just made it taste so good.
It did. It really, like, that little bit of fear has a tang in there that you just.
So, lamb chop over here is almost ready. I'm just gonna soothe her a little bit more, and then we'll commence the ritual of sacrifice before we prepare our lamb chop dinner.
I feel that, you know, I like my chops medium rare.
Do you wanna come and say goodbye?
Oh.
Now this is why I tell you about not taking the Pepto-Bismol.
I know, but it was so. It looks so good. 30 hot wings, 5 minutes. I could. I just almost did it.
You almost did it. And now you're about to do it in a fucking bathroom.
We're so considerate. All right, please bring them up.
Okay.
Oh, God.
All right. Are we making it here?
Okay.
All
right. Just stroke me. I'm fine.
Okay.
You're always so supportive.
Yeah, and I am kind of tired of playing this role for you. You're my little brother. How many times you gotta be on my teat?
It's just... I don't have any impulse control. That's what I need you for.
You're fucking 25. Do you not know when enough is enough?
Clearly not.
I can't continue to be your emotional crutch in your life. You have to man up.
I'm not ready to be a man. It's not in me. I just want to eat hot wings and sleep on mom's sofa all day.
Well, I can't move on with Tony and you in the room. You don't clean up the bathroom.
You want to move on with Tony?
Yes, you know I love him. Since sixth grade.
We're family. Fuck Tony.
Chip in. That's okay, the bed is made now. Cool.
Oh, I was just getting here. I was gonna help.
Oh, yeah. You look like you're definitely helping me. I appreciate that.
Mom, I just love having you around to take care of everything. Mom, you're in the way of the television. Mom.
Is this okay? Is this $95 cable I have okay?
There's a crease in the bed.
Yeah, can you iron that out, please?
Help.
Yeah.
Or see us help.
I wanted to spend
And I love it.
Where have I failed you as a mother?
You left me at camp.
You were six, it doesn't matter. Where have I failed you as a mother?
Were you saying something?
Chuck, I ain't sure if I'm gonna do good on this race. I've never driven a car this fast. And it's a Honda. Are you freaking out? You gotta be my rock, Chucky.
I'm scared.
Chucky.
Our whole lives have led up to this moment, and you, now you're scared, so I'm scared. Plus, you're driving, I'm just, you know, moral support.
Chucky, you're gonna be behind the fence. I need you to cheer me on. I need you to give me support, Chucky. Come on.
You can do it.
Oh. Chucky, I might crash. You want these to be the last words you say to me?
No, I don't. Let's just get in. Let's just go before anything else can happen. You got it.
Chucky, buckle up, Chucky.
Hold
it down.
What?
Chucky, I need you to be quiet. Chucky, shut up.
Okay. You know it's unconventional to have a passenger in such an important race.
You are slowing me down, Chucky. I need you to open the door and roll for it, okay?
What?
Get out of here, girls. Get out. You gotta get out.
No.
Chucky, I gotta win. Chucky.
I can't. I'll die.
Hey, Chucky. Well, we're doing business. That's what you gotta do. Let's go. Chucky,
are
I'm
you
always
serious?
With you. You
no,
gotta
you
go now.
You can't love me if you want me to commit a suicide, basically.
Well, just roll real fast. You'll be fine. I do.
I'm not going.
I'm ready for cosplay.
Scarlett O'Hara, my word. That is a bright red dress and you were looking fine.
I'm looking crimson in the cheeks, I do. I must say.
Now, what would Scarlett O'Hara say to,
I go red.
Oh, dear sir. I can't. With your chicanery.
I can show you the ways. The upside.
This cosplay is really spicing up the marriage, yeah?
Yes.
I'm getting a little bothered, as they say.
I'm picking up what you're laying down.
I am kind of ready to lay down in other areas.
Let me show you my lightsaber.
Ooh, what's called it on now? Yes, sir.
This red lightsaber's gonna look good on you.
Watch it, show me. Quack! Quack! Quack!
Jenny, what's wrong?
I don't want you to kill me. Quack!
Jenny, it's been a year. You know that's how we do it here.
I lick! Oh, Jenny. Quack! Here's some breadcrumbs for you before you go.
Jenny, better enjoy it. You know what's coming. Jesus, Jenny. All right, you're plump enough.
I'm really a good duck. Quack! I love you.
Yeah, Jenny, but, you know, it's Thanksgiving. Everyone's home.
It's a turkey day, not a duck day.
We're mixing up. We're doing a turducken.
Oh. Fucking South creating shit like that.
Jenny, now, I know we've had some good times.
You even let me sleep in bed with you. Come on, Jack. I've been a good duck.
You've been a good duck, but you'd be an even tastier duck.
I know that's true. It's a sad reality of my life.
Well, glad you're coming to terms with it. Alright, let's go to the slaughtering house. Come on.
I won't go without a fight!
You weigh like 2 pounds, Jen.
I'm small but mighty. Quack!
You're doing great, Mom.
Thank you, sweetie. I've been dying for your approval.
Yeah?
And your father's love, but I'm fine.
You'll be back soon, I'm sure.
Yes, yes. I've been, you know, very optimistic about that.
Yeah.
I know those 30 other women meant nothing to me.
Come in.
Honey, I heard you finally learned how to clean. So I came back after 20 years.
Dad, it's me. It's Jimmy.
Hi, Jimmy. I'm more interested in my woman than I am in you, so.
Yeah, totally.
Roger. My love. All those other women meant nothing.
I know.
I know. Oh.
You fucking bastard.
Whoa, that's not the kind of welcoming I was hoping for.
I know, it's just like, I gave you all my good news.
That's true, but you just needed a little more training. That you needed my absence to get stronger.
You're right.
I got stronger. I'm big and strong.
Sit down, this is
your fight. This is not about you.
Well,
at first I went down to Miami and I was with this hot babe named Veronica, but then she got a little boring, so then I went up to Canada and I was like, long story short, I've been a lot of places.
I know.
But then like I just felt it in my bones, it was time to come back to you.
And me?
It's not about you, son.
What was his name again? Gosh, I can't remember right now.
It's Jimmy!
Oh, little Timmy! I'll come to you later.
Your ass is calling me a self-involved brat.
Well, you were the only one here to parent him, so you're the only one to blame.
You're right. I've just fallen so short.
I missed you recently, which is why I'm back now.
Chucky, I'm so sorry I had to do that to you. But it seems you're all right.
I'm famous now. My full body cast has completely restored my body, and I'm more important in the world than you are. You're the asshole race car driver who pushed their best friend out of the car.
But I won the race!
And?
I got a trophy.
I got $2 million from your sponsors.
That's
and got you disbarred from NASCAR, so life is beautiful.
Chucky, I thought we were close. I thought we were close
until you almost killed me, man. I don't know what you expect from me now.
But Chucky, I was committed to the race, you understand?
Well, and I'm now committed to me.
Chucky, you're breaking my heart, man.
Well, you broke every bone in my body. So, I think we're even.
No, we're not even, Chucky. It's not fair. I want you back. I want to be friends again.
Nope.
Chucky.
We are from Queen Sister. We are going to do an improvised play for you. All we need to get started is one word, any word.
Bunny.
She
she's also my best friend. Because she's my only friend. But she's real soft, and she doesn't ask me things like, why didn't you do your homework this week, Amy? She never asks me anything like that. She just looks at me. Sometimes she bites me. But she's real soft, and she lets me hold her. So, honestly, I don't really see what friend could be better than that.
You know when you have a kid and you want to make the world amazing for them, but then no matter what you do, it seems that maybe you aren't doing good enough. Maybe you aren't creating a good enough world for them or something. I don't know, but it the kid just maybe feels like a disappointment. You can't say that to people. You can't tell people when they ask you how your kid's doing, oh, my kid's a disappointment with a happy face. So you lie and hope that you'll believe the lie? I don't know, maybe I'm thinking too much about it.
It's hard being a teacher these days. With all the social media pressures, everybody's put their pictures up on Instagram, trying to show how perfect they are. It's really stressful. And the kids who are popular, they're even more popular than when I went to school. The kids who are not popular, they're even more depressed than when I went to school. I feel good about the ones who are more popular, but the ones that are depressed, they are just so hard to deal with. It really makes me feel sad. And I just feel helpless. I feel like if I was a teacher 20 years ago, I might be able to be a mentor, a friend. But nowadays, if I even act like a friend, someone will tell on me on social media and I won't have a job anymore. And that would suck.
Lights up on a suburban living room. Big couch right in the middle.
There is a family around the table with food on the table.
There's a family portrait on the wall, like one of those big staged ones, but you can tell it's probably about 6 years old. Everyone in that photo does look pretty happy though.
There's some trash on like some of the surfaces. It hasn't really been tied. It's not like it's dirty, but it hasn't been cleaned in a while.
You can see that there's just a little bit of dust on the table that hasn't been cleaned in maybe a few days.
I just don't understand why we have to do family dinner.
I'm with you. This is such a waste of... I don't mean, but... Can't we just eat by ourselves?
Honey, you're supposed to support me. We're a team.
I just don't want to sit next to her when all she wants to talk about is that dumb rabbit.
Lexi. Don't talk about your sister that way.
Sheila's not dumb.
Thank you.
She's really soft. What does that have to do with anything? You can be dumb and soft.
Well, you're dumb and you're not soft, so...
Yeah, I go to the gym because I have friends. It's not me anymore.
You two were supposed to stop fighting once you got out of middle school.
I mean, like, says who, though, Dad?
I don't know, that's what all the parenting books say.
I just feel like Mom is on Facebook and she knows which one of us has more friends, and to be honest, it's not that surprising.
I need your support here.
Support.
I need more than just the, you saying the word support, obviously.
That's not fair to us. Not fair to you. Mom doesn't know everything.
I feel like you haven't even been listening.
I just feel like you're so pretty, and if you would just, like, and you're so, like, cool sometimes.
There we go, some compliments. Let's just end the sentence there. You don't need to keep going, Lessie.
I'm just saying, if she would just put the rabbit in a cage sometimes. Like, I just feel like people...
Sheila doesn't really like being in a cage.
Would
you want to be in a cage? Lexi, would you, like, what if, like, someone was like, you know what? Maybe instead of, like, sitting here at the dinner table, you could, like, sit in your room in a cage in the same place where you pee and poop.
I feel like I'm in a cage right now.
This family meal is just that. It's a nice time to get together once a week. It's really not that much. What would you be doing instead of this right now?
Well, first I would go on Instagram, and then I would see who responded to my selfie, and then if someone didn't answer, then I would send them a text message, and I would be like, hey, what is wrong with you? Why didn't you like my picture? I looked amazing. And by the way, I will use that filter on your pictures anytime you want. You just have to come and let me know. And then once I do that, then I might like do a little bit of English homework, but then I have to go on Facebook because I'm going to be going to this party in 2 weeks, but I'm not going unless Mark is there.
That's exactly why we'll be doing
it. Mary, how did you get in on all this? You just said you wanted a Facebook and then an Instagram. It was just to connect with our high school friends. Yeah, when it was just connecting, but now I feel like you're plugged in. That's what the news has been calling it. They're saying you can get legitimately addicted. They're saying it's an addiction, just like drugs. I wouldn't be okay if you were doing drugs.
It's true, Lexi. Your Instagram is like drugs.
Wow. I just, like, all I'm saying is that I really think that, like, if the two of us were, like, the cool sisters, there are no other cool sisters at our school, and... We could, like, I don't know, be on the student council or be on prom court or...
Those are very healthy things to want. Let's pursue excellence in academics.
Why would I want to do that? Because then we can get on a reality show.
Well, I don't know about that, but...
You could be on a reality show, too, and then they would play that, like, wah-wah music every time you came in the room.
Thank you, Lexi.
You're welcome.
If you want, I could play that music every time you come in the room.
Joke. That's really good. Boys like that. You should keep that up. See? I'm being nice.
You are. Sometimes you are very inconsistent.
You're being nice, but instead all you're doing is telling me how to be a different person than who I am.
I like to think that I'm just curating what is already there, but it's just like, it's just kind of like being covered up by this other stuff, like with the bunnies and not liking me and, I don't know, wanting to hang out with Dad. That's weird.
Blackout.
Lights up on a school cafeteria.
It's clearly the main group of people that, the kids, have mostly left. There's just a few people kind of milling around at the end of lunch, kind of picking up maybe the dregs of the people.
You can see a bunch of empty milk cartons and other plates and pizza left behind on the tables. Hey, what's wrong?
Oh, I'm fine.
You haven't played with your bunny today.
Well, I respected what you told me about the bunny not being allowed during the lunch period because of health code violations.
I know we do support, you know, the emotional support that's at Woodlawn High School, but not in the cafeteria.
She's really very clean.
I know. But, you know, the health office could shut us down.
Honestly, she's a lot cleaner than most of the kids who go here.
Well, unfortunately, it's not bunnies who wrote the laws.
It'd be better if it was.
You may be
you're right.
It'd be cuter.
Oh, it certainly would be. That's humans, though.
Yeah.
And you don't seem to be happy with her, without Sheila.
Well, it's just I don't know what to do with my hands. And it's one thing when you're, like, sitting by yourself and you have a bunny, because then you're not by yourself. I mean, you don't have a bunny.
How do you eat?
I mean, I don't, she sits in my lap while I eat, and I feed her some of my food. She doesn't, you know, bunnies don't just like carrots.
Really?
That's a common misconception because of cartoons.
You think that bunnies can actually eat the food in this cafeteria, though? Really?
Yeah, I mean, she likes french fries.
I never imagined a bunny eating french fries.
Well, she eats french fries. And cookies.
Wow. And yet she still managed to be really fit.
Well, you know, she gets a lot of exercise.
I'm really worried about you.
I'm fine, Mr. Smith.
You just seem to be lost, drifting away.
I mean, high school is only 3 more years, so I figure, you know, that's manageable.
Hey, it's good that you have a positive spin on things. That's, you know, it's a pretty long time. I mean, I've been working here for 5 years.
Really?
Yeah. I know, I am pretty sad.
Maybe you need an emotional support bunny?
But not in the cafeteria.
Sign on the wall advertising their prices, and you can tell this place is a real steal.
It's Mother's Day.
All right, Mom. I'm here.
Thank you for bringing me here. It's been a while.
Yeah, and I feel like when you're on your phone a lot, it's really important to take care of your nails, you know?
That's true. That's a great point.
These are the instruments that I'm going to use to take over the world.
I wish that your dad understands that.
I know. When you met him, did he, like, already just hate all the things that were fun?
No. He used to be youthful, fun, and, but ever since I got pregnant.
Oh, gross.
Thank you.
Okay, we have to take a selfie because we have to put this on Instagram because they said they'll give us 20% off if we tag them. Do you want to put it on my account or your account?
My account.
I don't want that guy to start sending me DMs again. Okay. Cheese. Oh, that's so nice. Okay, make sure you tag the store. It's spelled K-E-W-L-N-A-Y-L-Z. I think that's right.
N-A-Y-L-Z.
Think so. Yeah. That sounds right to me.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. So after we get our nails done, I guess we have to go pick her up for our Mother's Day lunch.
Yeah, we have to. I'm a little bit worried about your sister. Ever since the accident, she's just really, really dependent on her body.
I mean, all I was trying to do was just let that bunny have like a little bit of sunshine and fresh air, and then she like freaked out, and I was like, and she like ran right in front of the car to try to get him, and I was like, he's this big, he's not gonna get hit by the car. And really, like, and she still blames me for it, to be honest,
right.
Which I think is really unfair.
Yeah, I'm glad you're not taking it personal. It's really just her.
I mean, do you think that maybe we need to, like, get Sheila a friend? And then maybe she could, like, find a friend to take care of that bunny?
That's what I've been trying to do. But every time I introduce friends to her, she just kind of just closed off. And I don't know. Maybe it's not cool to have friends.
What? Having friends is the best. How do you know how many people think you're hot if you don't have friends that click like on your picture?
That's how I feel.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, I feel bad that a lot of your friends are like the creepy dads. But of all the friends,
they're not creepy.
They're a little creepy.
They are just being friendly. How can you say that?
I mean, all I'm saying is that one of them came up to me in the parking lot and he was like, hey, tell your mom if she wants to go to 80s night at the pub, I'll go with her. And I was like, first of all, that is so gross. Why do you want to remind me that
my
mom...
Who told you that? Why didn't you tell me earlier?
It was Mr. Donovan, but he's weird.
Donovan.
Why would you want to let people know that you remember stuff from the 80s?
Because that was a fun time. Alright, I got to touch base with Donovan. I was wondering how come I haven't heard from him.
What? Okay. I guess, like, you gotta be the Kris Jenner of your own life or whatever, but I can't deal with this. I'm gonna go pick out some nail polish colors. I can't be walking around.
Lights up on a classroom in the school. There is a teacher sitting at his desk. He has like a little nameplate on front of him that says counselor. Like it crosses out teacher and says counselor.
Mm-hmm. You can see a cage, a bunny cage in the corner of the classroom.
There is a family of four facing the counselor.
It's so good that you could all be here today.
You told me we had to come or we were going to get detention. I didn't really have a choice, so.
What was it that you two did this time?
It's not what I did.
It's not!
Amy, it can't never be your fault.
Okay, well this time it really wasn't. Okay. Okay. I just felt like if she's really doing this bunny thing, then I'm gonna support her. So I made Jack Willoughby go with me to the pet shop and we got a bunch of baby rabbits. And we maybe let a couple of them wander around in the science lab.
You can't get a rabbit if you can't provide a safe and loving home for it. It's not just like a toy.
You know what the students did in the science lab?
Okay, you know what? I thought it was really cute when they dressed them up in little hats, okay? And the bunnies did not seem to mind.
Yeah, but that's only the beginning.
Yeah, Lexi. That's only the beginning.
Okay, you know what? I am sure that all of the dye is going to wash out of the rabbit fur. And if it doesn't, then we will take
school spirit pictures, and we will print them out and put them all over the school, and that's a win for all of us.
Half their hair fell out! That dye is toxic! You can't just put it on a bunny! How would you like it if I put toxic dye on you? Just wait! Next time, while you're sleeping, I'm gonna come into your room and I'm gonna put toxic dye in your hair, and when half of it falls out, we can talk about how it's just so funny.
Do you hear this? She is threatening me. You need to suspend her.
Lexi, I think you need to hold the bunny.
Wait, why do you have a bunny as...
At Woodlawn High School, we are very supportive of emotional support.
Great, yep. Cool.
Mary, you leave me speechless.
Thank you.
I assume it's not going.
Wow. I just really, do you see how I just don't have anybody in this family that will believe me when I say that it was only 70% my idea to get these buddies?
Lexi, you know Mom always takes your side.
That's not true. I don't always take her side.
Oh, yeah, I am taking your side right now.
She won't buy me a car.
Oh,
that's not taking my side.
A car is expensive. A bunny is cheap.
Whoa.
Yeah, let's not use the word cheap.
Okay.
This is a very precious living creature.
Are you a representative of PETA? I don't understand why you're in this room right now.
I'm a counselor.
Bunny teacher. You have a bunny. You have a support bunny. You're
What's wrong with that, Dad?
Nothing.
No, tell me. What's wrong with my teacher having a support bunny?
There's nothing wrong with that. It's just... maybe. I thought people grew out of this. Maybe I thought that.
Well...
Dad's mad at you.
I'm not mad at anyone. I love you both so much.
Then buy me a car.
That's not what love is.
No, Lexi, you don't know what love is. You know why? Because all of your stupid friends that like your stupid Instagram selfies don't care about you. They think, oh, you look hot. Fire emoji. Girl. But that's not love, okay? Love is when you have a creature that only feels safe and comfortable when it's nestled up against you. And when you have a creature that makes you feel safe and warm at the same time that it feels safe and warm.
Lexi,
that's love!
How do you feel holding a bunny now?
Feel its little heartbeat.
That's really fast.
Okay, well, probably because it has had a really dramatic day.
You guys are really upsetting my bunny rabbit. I don't like that.
You hold it close to you.
Thank you.
It helps.
Aw, you calm down a little.
Yeah.
It is something.
Here.
It's your concert.
Oh, buddy.
As you can see, we are just not a normal family.
A little closer.
Yeah, you gotta hold it right here.
Kind of nestle it.
Yeah.
Mr. Sweeney, is there a bunny for my dad?
Of course. How many bunnies?
It is my dad.
She bought a lot of bunnies. It's really irresponsible. You should probably
be very careful. This bunny has had a really tough day.
We only have 89 left because Leslie Jansen took some home for her pool party. She's going to make sure that they float the whole time. It's going to be great.
Oh my God!
All right. I can only worry about 5 bunnies at a time. So let's worry about these bunnies.
Dad, hold it up to your chest.
We have to go save those bunnies.
Feel its little heartbeat.
Okay, but
feel it.
I do feel it.
Does anyone else care? We need to go get those bunnies out of the pool.
We've got more important things we're dealing with right now.
How could there be anything more important than saving those bunnies? I'm gonna get those bunnies!